jusqu'à 10.
What is up, guys? It's I, Bivins9, and today we're going to be talking about none other than the PS4. That's right. Just my all-around opinion of it. That's pretty much it. Let's just jump right into it. Let's see here. So, PS4. I don't know where to begin with this. I mean, it looks promising. It does. But first things first, the release date. Supposedly in America, they're releasing it in Christmas 2013. For the Europeans, they're saying they're gonna do the same thing and release it, you know, during holiday. But that might not be true. Because, you know, Sony makes promises that they can't keep. And even, they might make promises that they do intend to keep, but they don't because they never intended to keep because they suck. But I'm not gonna get into that. I don't want to go on a rant about how horrible Sony is. The graphics and processor. So apparently, it is the PS4 is rumored to have like 50% more compute units than the 720 that Microsoft is going to be releasing around the same time. It has an 8-core Jaguar AMD CPU, which apparently is better than the AMD. The leading desktop chip, the AMD A5 or A10 5800K or something like that. I think that's the name of it. That's the chip that I've got in my PC. But it also has a 1.84 teraflop AMD GPU. And before I get into the 1.84 teraflop thing, it's good to know that they're using AMD for their processing stuff in this console. AMD doesn't get a lot of things. I like AMD. I mean, there is the long argued debate that Intel is better than AMD, but really it just depends on what you want to do with your system. And this is the same thing. I mean, I think this is going to be a great console for hardcore gamers because the PS3 was a really great console besides the whole jailbreaking and PS and down-edge things. But besides that, it was a great console. And I'm not going to ditch my PS3 for the PS4. I mean, I still have a PS3 and I play most of my games on Xbox, but I still crack out my PS3 from time to time and play something like Little Big Planet, even though I don't play that a lot, so I don't know. It's a good console. The PS4 appears to be the same quality of the PS3, if not better. I mean, and a teraflop. Let's get into that. Apparently, a teraflop, according to a quick Google search, means a teraflop is equal to 1 trillion. That's right. 1 trillion floating point operations per second. Excuse me. Now, to put this in comparison for you, the Cray XT4, which I believe is one of Cray's best products, hit a 101.7 teraflops. That 101 teraflops versus Sony's, what's it, 1.84 teraflops. That's like, Sony's, in a nutshell, just created a really, 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 really low-end supercomputer. Or they've made a console with the graphics capabilities of a low-end supercomputer. I don't know. It does look promising in some aspects. It's got 8 gigabytes of DDR5 RAM. Now, all I gotta say about this is, what the hell is DDR5 RAM, and how do I get my hands on it? Because as far as I know up until this point, was the best you could get was DDR3. I mean, and quick Google search, GDDR5 RAM. Apparently, it's based on DDR3 SD RAM. Apparently, it's really new. I mean, Quamanda demonstrated it in 2008. Nothing really come of it. It's graphics memory, so apparently no DDR5 for me unless I buy a new graphics card. But right, all the standard good Sony things, like a Wi-Fi card, USB 3.0, which is good, it's a good thing, Bluetooth, Ethernet, standard auxiliary components, HDMI, analog AV, and digital output, as per usual, I guess. That's pretty much it. For me, the Sony PS4, and they did redesign the controller, the DualShock 4. One of the big issues is supposedly there's not going to be any cross-compatibility, which is going to be a big peeve for me. So I can't play the PS3 games on the PS4, which is really going to piss me off, because, like, all those great titles, like, Modern Warfare 2 things, unless they make them again for PS4, it's just going to be a pain. But on to the graphics, the internal software side of it. The new menu layout and the GUI, they've made it look so much like the Xbox home screen. It's a little bit funny, but not that much. It's proves to just be more annoying than anything else, but I don't know. I mean, the Xbox home screen is great, but the whole ads thing, I'm not down with that. I mean, I paid for a $300 game console. I don't know how much Xbox retails for now. Mine is like $250, I think. But, I paid for like a $300 gaming console, right? I expect to not see ads on the freaking dashboard. Jesus. But this is one of those Microsoft things, getting money where they can. I can't blame them either. Sony knew better. They didn't do that with their PS3. Or at least they only showed proprietary text-only ads in the top right-hand corner. But there's the potential for them to put ads, not just a whole bunch of ads in there. It could be annoying. I don't know. It's just me. But, yeah, that's my rant on the PS3 and all things PS3 related. This is iBivins9, narrating for the iRock with a Glock channel. Signing off. And also, check my channel out. There's a link in a couple seconds. Just click that to go check my channel out. Thanks. Bye.
I am the Buddhist man, coming from family's land. I am the Buddhist man, coming from family's land.